There you go. And that's why you come to the Red River right there.
I mean, he's a good. And boy, when they get,
there's the bulldog
right here, as he calls it.
There we go.
How about that, boys?
Got him.
Man.
There we go.
That's a good one.
That's a big fish.
But I'll tell you what, hillbilly like me, that's a dang good channel cat right there. We're up here in the North Country catching some of the finest channel cats you'll ever see right here on today's G3 Sportsman. Stick with us. Get him.
I'm gonna tell you something right there.
Good girl.
That is a good.
I gotta get him out of that.
That's a heck of a crappie right there.
Now get out of her way.
That's a good start right there.
Tell you what.
The G3 Sportsman is presented by Yamaha. Reliability starts here.
You know, here on the G3 Sportsman, we try to venture out to different parts of the country so we can highlight some of the different areas and whatnot. But the one area that we really haven't focused on is the north. And I'm talking about way up north. Today, we are in Grand Forks, North Dakota. We're not far from the Canadian border. And we're going after channel cat. And I'm not talking about just regular channel cat. I'm talking about some big channel cat right here on the Red River. One of the most famous places for trophy channel cat. And we're with the best guy that we could possibly be with, and that is Brad Durick. He's been fishing this river for quite a few years now, and he is the go-to guy for big channel cat. And here in a bit, you're gonna see why. Feels nice in here, got a little pocket in here, and got a little good little current. Seen bait fish sitting in about 18 feet of water right here. It's probably, what,
six?
Six bait in there. Same routine, we'll just kind of chunk up in there and wait a few minutes and see what happens. I'm ready to see my first North Dakota cat. Does he just go meow like our Ozark's cat, or does he go meow?
No, it's more like roar. Yeah. They roar up here.
You know you're in a cold place when you can see bark stripped off the trees due to ice.
Probably right down that seam, and I'll go right between the two. This one just got hit. Perfect. Come on. Come on.
Well, I'd say he's hooked. Is he hooked?
Yep, so far.
Okay.
There he's bulldogging a little. There's bulldogging a little.
And you really like him 8-foot rods too, don't you?
I like an 8-foot rod. You can see I'm not pulling drag here. That's not a bad fish at all.
Okay.
It's not, see how it's flexing the rod rather than
right.
Pulling the drag.
Right, I got you, yeah.
This is not a bad fish at all.
If you ready?
Can. There you go. And that's why you come to the Red River right there.
Man, let me tell you, boys, this is not a blue cat. This
get that
is
out of your hair.
A channel cat.
Short and stout, kind of like me.
Yeah.
And you know, you get these up into 20, add 3 inches and a whole bunch of girth to it is basically what you're getting.
Yeah.
But not a mark on them, they're all clean.
Yeah, very nice. All right, we're gonna let this fish go. We may take a picture of it or whatnot, but here in a little bit after the commercial break, we'll be back up here in North Dakota, up here in the Red River, catching big channels. What you supposed to say? You betcha.
You betcha. I'm from here and I don't say you betcha.
We'll see you here in a little bit. That's a nice one. That's a nice one right there. It's tough, strong,
enough. Keeps on going when the going gets rough. Cater tough, strong enough. Everything you need. Summer, spring, winter, fall. G3 lets you do it all. There's nothing like a Cater Tough G3. No, there's nothing like a Cater Tough G3.
Visit G3Boats.com to find your nearest G3 and Yamaha outboard motor dealer.
Some hunters only stand in the bargain line, and there are others who will never stand behind any brand, but some will always stand for quality without compromise. Where do you stand? Fiocchi. What's in your gun?
Garmin says their new Echo fish finders are simply the best fish finders for the money.
I'll echo that.
Right. Garmin also says you'll be impressed with the Echo fish finder's excellent power, screen clarity, and free transom and trolling motor mounting kit.
I'll echo that.
A nice, bass.
I'll echo that.
Why is it looking at me?
It's got the punch of a heavyweight and the pounds of a lightweight. Welcome to the main event featuring the new Yamaha 4-stroke F70. Tipping the scales at up to 142 pounds lighter than its 4-stroke competitors. That's a class-leading power-to-weight ratio. A haymaker of a hole shot. Surprising mid-range punch. Incredible fuel economy. And industry-leading innovation, performance, and reliability. The Yamaha 4-stroke F70. Reliability starts here.
The segment of the G3 Sportsman is brought to you by G3 Boats, a great catch. Fiocchi Ammunition, what's your game? Abu Garcia, for life. And by Garmin, we'll take you there.
Well, what makes the Red River so, I mean, what makes these channel cat grow this size here in this part of the country?
Well, I've read a lot about the whole slow growing season.
Uh-huh.
And I guess I can believe that because they can get older. Down where you guys are at, their metabolism is going all year long because you don't have the freeze up.
Yeah.
So they don't have that slow time. So it's almost like, and this is just my reading, it's almost like they've used their whole lifespans of metabolism up in a shorter distance before they can grow that big. Now, just take into the human aspect of it. We're in walleye world. Almost none of these big fish ever get kept.
Yeah.
They're always just rolled back into the river. So we have a lot of good catch and release and good management. We also have a very strict limit of 5 fish with only one can be over 24 inches if you are going to keep fish.
Mm-hmm.
So in the terms of the human element, it's very advantageous for the catfish.
He's just banging on it right there, waiting on him to just take it. Is this one on, you think?
Just give it a little bit of a hook set and reel down.
There we go. I've been watching that outside one over there. And this one on the inside came on and got it. So I don't know. We'll have to keep an eye on that one out there.
We'll watch.
Though. You know, something that we hadn't touched on is this equipment that we're using right here too. We're using these 8-foot ugly sticks, and there's no better rod really to use because it's just strong. You got a sensitive tip on there. And
maybe step a little to the front of the boat, Scott.
And you can just control your fish better. That's not as big as the other one, but I'll tell you what,
that's still a stout little guy.
These rods are just perfect for what we're doing out here, right here. Twenty-five inch,
still in the pre-spawn.
Yeah.
Real chunky fish.
You know, in between catching the big ones, it's fun. I mean, that's everybody's normal size channel cat right there. Is that size, and we all think back home that's a big one. So, shoot, ain't nothing wrong with that one. But we'll
say hi.
We'll put that little rascal in, and we'll go get her grandma.
Come on, buddy.
Nothing like coming into a new river and a new land that I've not been in a fine boat. How about this?
Come on, set it. There you go.
We might have this one.
That's going to be a good fish.
That feels like a good fish unless he's in that.
There's nothing to snag in.
Man.
Check your drag just for safety.
I've been watching this outside pole for a while, finally. And what I was talking about earlier, look at this rod here and what we're using in this 8 foot. As Brad said earlier, with these longer rods, you're actually being able to fight the fish more with the rod and not use the drag. The reels we're using is one of the most common and most popular catfish reels. He's Abu Garcia 6500 C's. They've been around forever, haven't they, Brad?
They've been around longer than I have, and they're still the best reel on the market.
Yeah, they really are. Using 30-pound trilene line, big game. Man, boy, these things, you can't imagine how strong they are.
There, we're getting close.
Good grief. That's the one! That's the one! Woo! That's what I'm talking about right there. Oh,
that's the one.
That's why you come to North Dakota to catch channel cats on the famous Red River with Brad Durick, right there.
Okay. There you go.
There you go. That's what I'm talking about right there, boys. Look at that big, big-headed rascal right there. That is nice. You could tell how hard they fought, man. That rod was bent double. Great looking fish. Man, and he's heavier than what you think. This fish is bigger than what you think. And this is channel cats. I know we keep harping on it, but these are channel cats that we're catching. People come from all over the country to come up here and fish with Brad on the Red River. And it's a very nice fish right here, I'll tell you. Couldn't be more pleased, Brad.
I'm glad you're having fun.
I'm always watching those other ones. You know, the opportunity to come to North Dakota has been 3 years in the making. Brad contacted me a while back and got me kind of intrigued about the fact that you could really catch trophy size catfish in the Red River. This year we said, you know, we're going to make the trip happen, and wouldn't you know it, we'd have high water.
It's fairly typical to have a summer flood, but nothing like this. So we're in some what I would call hostile conditions for these channel cats. But you know, the way things have been and just playing it smart, I think some great things are going to happen here. The Red River is known for its channel cats. It is, and I'm a little bit partial, the best channel cat fishery in North America.
So what are we using? Suckers?
White suckers.
White suckers.
Natural to the body of water, a little angry at this point. We cut these up into, this guy will make about 5 nice baits.
Okay. All right, this has been a great spot right here. We caught 3 fish off of it. We're gonna ease on down a little bit, and we're gonna try another little spot over here. And if I talk long enough, Brad will get all these poles reeled in. But anyway, this is the way it is up here. You know, just like any of the other catfish shows that you've seen us do, we go in a spot, you know, we fish for a little while, and sure enough, we get 2 or 3, just move on to the next spot. Even up in North Dakota, they still do the same thing. So let's get them up, get moving, catch some more.
Hey, Scott, we got a fish going over here.
Yeah, it is.
Go get him.
Man.
Go get him.
I'm going to get him.
I'm going to get him.
That's a good one.
I'm going to get him.
Man, oh man, oh man. Look at that. I mean, look at the bow in that rod right there. And he's trying to run to that wood, I bet, isn't he? You think?
I don't think he's close enough to get in there. I think he'll muscle him out.
Just let your great catch begin with your family and friends. America's going fishing with G3. With G3.
Visit G3boats.com to find your nearest G3 and Yamaha outboard motor dealer.
I tell you what, waterfowlers, I shoot a Beretta Extrema 2.
I just can't believe how universal in its application this gun is. And it fires every time I squeeze the trigger.
Here they come, here they come.
There's no question that this thing works in all conditions.
That's the best shotgun I've ever shot.
Take them.
The real deal is that the gun just works and works and works.
Good shot. Wow.
Get inside the Beretta Extrema 2. Blast off at BerettaUSA.com.
This segment of the G3 Sportsman is brought to you by Beretta. 500 years, one passion. Mossback fish racks. No matter how you stack them, we attract them. Berkeley, catch more fish. Shakespeare, quality fishing tackle since 1897. And by Yamaha. Reliability starts here.
It's all a big system when it comes to this catfish, from the reels, the line, the rod, and especially your rod holder right there. Them rod holders right there, those Driftmaster rod holders, and these circle hooks work as one unit. Isn't that right, Brad?
That's right.
So then when they hit and load up those rods, it sets the hook itself. You don't really have to. I mean, this whole thing just comes together.
The amount of big fish that you have to catch to wear one out is just unbelievable.
Yeah, there's no doubt. We're getting closer. We're getting closer. You notice my rod even says catfish right there.
Let him in, let him in, let him in, let him in. Got him.
Man.
There we go.
That's a good one.
That's a big fish. Oh, my, my, my.
Oh, yeah.
That's a nice one.
Man, I tell you what, they get out there in that current. They will whip you to pieces now.
Pound for pound, I don't think there's a stronger fighting fish that knows how to use current to his advantage.
Look. Look at there. Son, that is a beautiful channel cat. I mean, ain't a mark on her. Man, this thing is heavy, too. Look at the head on that thing. What do you think this is, Brad? 17? Maybe?
17 to 18.
Yeah. I mean,
17 to 18
getting to where
pounds.
We're catching so many of them, I kind of know what the sizes are on them. And I mean, this thing is just, boy, I mean, you just can't imagine. Just look how thick it is. And that's just solid right there. Look at that. And the reason why they got the power is them tails, too. Right there. North Dakota Red River Channel Cats. It don't get no better than this.
It is a most unique system. It flows, of course, the border between North Dakota and Minnesota. And it has been historically one of the great premier catfish areas in the country for years. And it's very interesting that it really hasn't been discovered by a lot of people until basically late 60s, 70s, and then it got noticed. In the Red River, it's north. It's one of those things that you wouldn't think about it because, face it, it's cold up here. And these fish are long-lived, slow-growing. But they grow big, they grow fat.
You can see how that sinker slides up there. Now, what was the deal with the what you've got right here on the leader?
All I did was used a snell knot, which is not, it's, some people use it, some people don't. I use about a 9-inch leader because we're dealing with heavy current and I don't want to get in the snags.
Right.
So it's less to get caught up,
so that's
less to flop around.
All that's for is for this right here, just for your bait to kind of go around.
I use the old snell knot when I tie my hooks. The same as like walleye spinners would be tied with, rather than a polymer knot or a tri-leading knot, where it's wrapped around the shank and just comes up so you've got the whole pull of the shank and not necessarily on the line.
I'm gonna get this one while you're doing that.
Yeah, you do that.
I'm gonna go ahead and I've been watching this while you're doing this, but you go right ahead. It never fails. It's so funny, we try to show you what kind of rig and everything else and these fish think, okay, they're...
That looks like a nice fish.
That's not bad. I played him as long as I could so you could finish. And boy, when they get...
There's the bulldog.
Right here, as he calls it.
There we go.
How about that, boys? Right, boys and girls.
That look. Fish came out of a root ball in about 6 feet of water.
Mm-hmm. There we go.
Nice fish.
How about that?
Nice fish.
How about that? Channel cats up here in the North Country.
What do you think of fishing up here now in flood and wind and...
You know what I say to that? You betcha. That's what I'm talking about right there. Red River channel cats. All right, put you back. I'll wait for a big one. There it goes.
There we go.
There we go, right here.
Go get it.
Right there. You want me to get him this
You're
time?
You're gonna go get it.
Oh! Couldn't even hardly get him out of the rod holder. Hey. You're gonna have to get that one.
All right.
Is he on there?
He's on. Don't wrap up. Hey, we got a double going. What do you know?
How about that?
We had to threaten to leave.
How's your fish feel?
Pretty nice, fair.
What happened to my net man?
He'll come. You just let me know. You just let me know. I'll be there. I'm gonna see how good I am at netting with one arm.
Well, here, let me.
I'll get him.
Well, I can do what you're doing.
Are you ready?
All right, I'm fixing to pull him up. Hey, right there.
Pull him up.
Okay, let me have it.
Got him?
Yeah. Man, look what a big-headed rascal right there. Good gracious. Let me get these pliers. All right. Where we at? I'm not used to netting. No offense.
Okay, you ready? Okay, I'm going to... Here he comes. Right there. Man, got him?
That's a real good one right there.
That's a nice fish. That's
I mean,
a big
that
one.
That one is a real.
That's the 20 pounder right there.
Man,
that's her. That's it.
That is a
that's the one.
Good one.
Here we go.
Introducing a revolutionary way to attract fish, the Mossback Fish Rack. From the box to the water, setup is a snap, and you can be fishing in no time. The rough surface on the branches encourages algae growth, and the unique design virtually eliminates hanging hooks. Use the Mossback Fish Rack in your pond, hang it off your dock, or sink it in your local lake. Join the guides, pros, and weekend fishermen who are already reaping the rewards. No matter how you stack them, we attract them. To learn more, visit mossbackrack.com.
I was so sick of him fishing, I ran over his ugly stick with his own truck.
Don't get me wrong, I couldn't be happier that he found a hobby.
Oh, time to go fishing today, Harry!
I'm a peaceful person.
So I gave it to our dog, Sugar, as a chew toy.
Your mama, her husband back!
What is that thing made of?
You know what happened?
Nothing!
Absolutely nothing.
Nothing.
Ugly Stick, tested under some of the harshest conditions on Earth.
Stupid Ugly Stick.
The Yamaha VMAX SHO. First, it changed the game. Now, it set the standard. But don't take our word for it.
The whole shot was everything they said it was going to be.
And we accelerated from like 50 miles an hour to 70, and it was like that.
So fast. So quiet.
I mean, you give it power, and it's just there.
That thing right there is just bad.
The whole shot on it, it's second to none.
Oh, yeah. It's for real.
Take a demo ride and feel the power yourself. You'll know why we call it the Game Changer.
Designed backed by cutting-edge precision. Sophistication that's world-renowned. Durability that's not to be outdone. So why do we insist on such perfection? We know what's at stake. Veritas and Verdict, the next generation of the V-Series from Abu Garcia for life.
Channel cat at its best. The reason why people come to North Dakota, especially right here in Grand Forks on the Red River, is this right here. The biggest channel cat you'll catch about anywhere right here. Brad Durick's the man. Thank you, sir.
Thanks for coming up.
Man, this is an incredible fishery. Proof's in the pudding, boys. I'm telling you, this is a big male right here. And there's the female. So this is a pair beat a full house any day right here. No question about it. What a great, great time. All right.
a happy couple here.
Come on, girl. Oh, mine's just gone.
Boy, no kidding. Hey, thank you. You know, that's all the time we got for this week's show. But I tell you, we've had a ball down here. You want to catch the biggest channel catfish you ever caught in your life? The best chances of doing that is right here on the Red River, Grand Forks, North Dakota, with Brad Durick. Captain Brad right there, now he'll put you on them. You'll have a ball, you have a big time. And I'm wore out. I'll tell you what, it's good. A big day of catching big fish. And I tell you, we gotta go. We gotta sign off. Can't believe we got it all in here. But just remember, we'll be out there somewhere next week, right here on the G3 Sportsman. Thanks for watching. Man, what a day. What a day. You caught one.
I caught one.
The G3 Sportsman is brought to you by G3 Boats, a great catch. Bioki Ammunition, what's your game? Abu Garcia, for life. Garmin, we'll take you there. Beretta, 500 years, one passion. Mossback Fish Racks, no matter how you stack them, we attract them. Berkeley, catch more fish. Shakespeare, quality fishing tackle since 1897. And by Yamaha, reliability starts here.
We're up in the North Country. You betcha.
I don't think, got off.
Okay, that was just a trial run. We just caught us an Uncle Bill special right here. Gasper Goo.
Fish, gotta be kidding me. No, no, that didn't just happen.
You lost him again? Brad Durick, LLC.